last time on Skyrim. There he had entered the Hall of Dead Draugr, which will likely lead to the Potato God. Also, have I mentioned how much I enjoy this game? It is amazing. It's the only term for it. It is phenomenal. I say that as a person who has played a considerable amount of not only RPGs, but Bethesda games. I didn't start with Arena, I actually started with Daggerfall. I know there are probably some of you who are like, what? You didn't make fun of Dan. Well, what the shit was that? I wonder if we need that. Let's take it. Might need it to get into that area. Oh, okay.
Not much further. Come with me. Serve me in death.
Told ya. She wants some face. Some dead face. Oh, Lord. Yes, I did just close the damn door. Not much further. I'm not gonna stick around and service her with her twisted desires. Even dead women, I tell you, you know. Live women and dead women. Do this, do that, all the time. That's all I ever hear. Do the dishes. Give me some face. No, I'm just kidding. I'm kidding! I'm sorry. Yeah, I'll shut up now. Yeah, I'll definitely shut up now. Give me one second. What the fuck just happened there? Also, I'm really glad that Jailu doesn't watch these because I make comments like that. She would lose her shit. She would not be impressed anyway. Let's just say that. Now, if you steal the weapon off of the undead that's arisen, does it... Yeah, I don't know why we'd search the empty Draugr, because... Yeah, we'll take that. Like, does that... You know what I'm saying. Does that particular NPC not get the weapon that they would have normally carried? Like, if I take that honed sword, does he not get that honed sword? Also, for those commenters who really don't care about being politically correct or any of that stupid crap, I am curious, what do you think happens after death? Do you think you end up wrapped up in some weird shit like this guy? Do you think you just become worm food, or do you think there's something else? What do you think happens after you pass? Not pass wind, because we all know what happens after that. You feel relieved and it's all good for a while. But, as long as you're alone. Because if you pass wind in front of other people, that's not as cool. And, people tend to, sorry, I got a little distracted. Yeah. Especially when you get married. Yeah, it suddenly becomes a lot less cool. It's still damn funny, though. Give me one second. Alright. But you have to time it right. Flatulence is all about timing, if you plan on making people laugh about it. Because just doing it for no reason is not cool. That is, you know, that'll just get you in trouble. But if you can time it, you know, properly, I know that sounds, you're like, what? You can, oh lord. Sigh, okay. Yeah, we're not getting rid of that, so... Nah. You know what, I really don't want to give that away either. I was planning on giving that to that weird child. May have to drop this. Don't want to drop this, but... Sometimes you just gotta drop the ancient Nord helmet. Anyway, yeah. If you're planning on breaking wind in front of your friends, make sure that you time it correctly. Okay. Oh, good. Well, this looks like it should be easy. Without actually confirming, I'm going to say that that is Patema. And I'm going to fire around. That did nothing. Great. But something is moving. Oh, crap. Okay, so there is a Draugr right there. Well, let's put one in it. Scourge, no less. Great, that's fantastic, because those are easy. Let's, in fact, get away from that thing, Larry. Are there doors we can close along the way? There's a door right there. Okay, good. Okay. So the potato god has guards. Which really, why wouldn't you? If you were a potato god, you'd have guards too. Where the fuck did that scourge go?
You've come far, mortal. But can you stand against my inner council?
Oh, shit.
Let's see.
Oh, good. Oh, nice. A lightning laser beam. That's fantastic. I was hoping the potato god would have one of those. In fact, yeah. Great. That's great. Okay. Is that the scourge? And all we did was piss something off. Well done, Larry. Lovely. Wow. That lightning lasted a long, long time. can't imagine doing this game on Master without a bow and arrow. I would imagine it's something akin to using sandpaper on your buttocks after you've taken a shat. After thee hast shat on thy throne. Let's wait for the lightning laser. Okay. Oh, crap. There's the scourge. Na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na. There's three of those bastards. Let's close the friggin' door and run the fuck away. That's right on the other side of this door. No, it's not. So we're safe. Yeah, okay. Alright. You know what? Larry's not doing too bad here. If he can knock these guys down a fair amount and then not get hit by the lightning laser and, you know, maybe use the Dremora, we may actually survive this. Meanwhile, the Dremora are wondering what the hell is going on. Why do we keep getting hit in the head with these? Yeah, open the door. Larry dares ya. It's gone already. Why is the lightning laser... Oh. Because Larry left the door open like a moron. Actually, he didn't. They did. No. Oh, fudge it. Now that is how it's done. In case you guys were wondering. In case you didn't already know how it was done. That right there is how it's done. Not really, of course. It's probably done with a lot more finesse than that, but... Okay. Lightning laser. Put one in him.
Don't applaud yourself too soon, worm.
What the shitting A? Why can you resurrect that friggin' thing? I suppose because you're the potato god. And as the potato god, you have control of vodka. Which allows you to resurrect whatever the hell you want. Unfortunately, you can only resurrect them for a limited length of time. Which is what happens when you try and get erect with vodka. It doesn't last. It only happens for a limited length of time. Possibly a limited length. Oh, Lord. Let's get away from that thing. You know what? Larry's got a sword for you. Or you could just run away. That works as well. The Draugr can be healed by what? The friggin' lightning laser beam? Get your ass back here. Get out of the way, Larry. Where did it go? Great. Did I just get hit by the lightning laser? No. Of course not. That would make the game too awesome. If the stupid bag could kill her own people. Nice. Well done, Larry. Okay. Take a quick breather. Enjoy our triumphant, you know, the fact that we lived through that. All right. Okay, Potato God. Anything else to throw at Larry? Okay, so the Potato God is pissed off. This is what that seems to imply. Larry is now able to float, which is nice. You know what? Instead of getting stuck in the head and torso with some ice, oh God! There's the scourge. Yeah, we're not gonna stick around and play a game of tag with that jackass. Yes, I am hoping that the, whatever it's called, the ice Atronach will disappear. I knew that was too easy. Bring your ass over here. Keep going, Larry. You keep gloating, you piece of shit. Put one in him, Larry. Don't let him... Right in the knee.
Rip the eyes from his head!
You ain't ripping shit from shit, lady. And we've managed to save the Dremora for what will likely be the worst part of this battle. We may even be out of time. Oh, God, really? Shit, that thing doesn't matter. Bring it on. As it floats towards Larry. Okay. Yeah, we're probably... Oh, fudge. Yeah, we've gotta be seriously out of time by this point. So, next time on Skyrim, more Potato God with her lightning laser beam. Stay tuned.